Senator Marsha Blackburn, the Republican senator from the beautiful state of Tennessee. Senator, good to have you. This is just the latest example of how one executive order can spill over and cost and mean a lot of jobs, and not just directly in the energy industry, but those kind of dependent on that. Where do you see this going, Senator?
One of the things that is concerning to all of my county mayors in Tennessee is what is going to happen to the energy cost, how that is going to drive up their cost of doing business, if you will, in those counties. And Neil, the other thing that they're talking about is their concern over this $15 an hour minimum wage and how harmful that is going to be not only to local employers, but also to county governments and the pressure that is going to put on their budgets. They've done a great job. I tell you, Tennessee has done a great job of weathering this pandemic, and our counties have done a great job of getting people back to work, children back in school, and working hard on that environment. And they're looking at these executive orders. And I was talking to one of the counties this morning, and they said, where is this going to stop? If energy is going to cost more, if those jobs are leaving, if you're going to see less manufacturing in the country, what is that going to mean to us?
If I could switch gears, you talked about, you know, the COVID effect as well, Senator. And right now, even though the president did meet with a number of your Republican colleagues to hammer out a bipartisan plan, the talk is that all that just might be talk, that the president is being urged even to use reconciliation, a method by which you just need a simple majority of senators to pass that $1.9 trillion plan, including that $15 minimum wage feature. How do you feel about that? Do you feel that if he goes through with that, bipartisanship is just a non-event for this administration?
Yeah, and you know, what is so interesting is we're going to have that vote to proceed to a budget resolution this afternoon. And you know what the budget resolution is? At this point, it is this. It is a bunch of top-line numbers. There is no detail. And all you're going to do is see this, pass these budget numbers, then the committees are going to go fill this out and decide how to spend this pocket of money. Relief should be targeted, it should be temporary, and it should be timely. And what we are seeing is $3.6 trillion is already out the door. You know what? The last tranche of money that was passed in December, those checks are not even to the states. So they're not even to your local communities yet. But yet they want to bump this number up to $5.5 trillion by passing another $1.9 trillion. When you haven't even gotten the checks out the door for the last round of funding. This is something that is just ridiculous. But bear in mind, you've got Bernie the Budget Buster, who is now chairman of the Senate Budget Committee, and you've got Joe the Job Killer, who is the President of the United States and is signing these executive orders that we know have already adversely impacted over a million jobs.
But you know, Senator, they come around and point to the Federal Reserve, which said, go big on stimulus. You can regret going too small. You won't regret going too big. What do you say?
All you have to do is look at what we went through from 2009 to 2016, and you see what a slow stimulus looks like when the federal government is trying to micromanage economic growth. The best economic stimulus there is a job. And it is the government's responsibility to create the environment for jobs growth to take place, then get out of the way and let the private sector do what they are good at doing. And to try to micromanage this, to do these executive orders that favor China when you're looking at energy and you're looking at minimum wage and you're looking at manufacturing, my goodness, let's be for the American worker. Let's be for getting them back to work. Right. Let's be for robust economic growth.
All right, Senator, thank you very, very much. Senator Marsha Blackburn on all of that. And again,